At first glance, this 3D model looks like a normal cube, but notice the information about its geometry, its vertices, edges, and faces. Here we see that this cube has 17 vertices, 24 edges, and 10 faces. In wireframe mode, it also appears to be a normal cube, but what we have here are duplicated vertices. That means that at some point we did some operation or something that introduced new geometry that overlapped with the existing geometry. This is very common to happen, for example, when we select a face and make an extrusion, but we press right click. Now, here we may think that the operation was cancelled, but in reality, what happens is that this new face was created, but it was placed in the same position as the original face. So those new vertices overlapped with the others. And now we have this situation, 21 vertices, 14 faces. So let's see how to solve this. For that, we will select all the vertices that we want to analyze. In this case, I'm gonna select everything by pressing the A key several times. Then I'm gonna press F3, look for merge, and I will choose the option merge by distance. When you execute this operation, pay attention here below. You will see a message with the result of the operation. In this case, 13 vertices were removed. And as you can see here in the poly count, now we have a normal cube with 8 vertices and 6 faces. Something to take into account is this window that appears when we execute the merge by distance function. It allows us to configure the distance from which two vertices will be merged. That is, if two vertices are closer than the distance that is written here, Blender will merge them. And we can change this distance. For example, here I set 10 centimeters, and the result of the operation in this particular case is exactly the same. But you have to be careful, because from now on, in this Blender file, when you use the merge by distance function again, for example, let's quickly add a sphere. If I use the merge by distance function again, Blender will consider the last distance we wrote, and that could bring issues depending on the model we're working with. Note that here some vertices were removed, but they were not duplicated vertices, but important vertices that were part of the sphere. So if you're gonna modify this distance, be careful with this. That's all for this video. I hope you found it useful, and see you in the next one. Tschüss!